got Alzheimer's.
Well, that was awesome. Thank you, Morag.
Oh, you are welcome.
Well, it's getting late, so I think I'm going to get an early night.
Yes, what a good idea.
What are you pokers talking about? It's still early.
Well, there's nothing wrong with having an early night every so often. What do you say, darling?
Oh, Ruby's here. I can stay up a bit later tonight.
Oh, look, let's just call it a night for now, and maybe we can have lunch with Ruby and Charlie tomorrow.
Well, if I get into work early, I could take a long lunch.
Well, now, isn't it great that you've retired and you don't have to worry about things like that anymore?
On second thoughts, I'm going to shoot off as well. I've got lots of assignments to do and I should probably make a start on some of them. Dad, you look a bit tired.
Yeah. All right. I'm sorry, darling. I got worry tomorrow. No, no.
Night.
Night, Ron.
Rooster, forget your bag.
Hey, are you okay?
Yeah.
Because I know Charlie's been busy at work, so if you need to talk about anything...
No, I'm fine. Thanks, Roman. I'll see you later. Rooms, what are you doing here? I thought you were having dinner with Dad.
Been there, done that, tick.
Oh, Morag's cooking can't have been that bad, surely.
Wasn't the reason I left. Dad was tired. I didn't want to wear him out. You know how it is.
Okay. Well, I'm just having a quick drink with the guys, and then I can give you a lift home if you want.
No, I might head off. I need to drop by Annie's on the way. I've got some questions about Simon.
Did everything go all right at dinner?
Yeah, it was fine. I'll catch you later.
Hear someone up and about early this morning.
Yeah, I thought I'd get up, go for a walk.
I guess you didn't sleep very well.
What are you, part-time shrink or something?
No, I've been a mum for a while.
Wish mine was here right now. Might make the whole thing a bit easier.
If you need an ear, maybe a shoulder, I'm always here.
Thank you. But I'm doing all right. I like to think I'm pretty strong, you know, being from a family of cops and everything.
Ruby, what your dad is going through would be hard on anyone. But when you're only 15...
No, you're right. We need to be strong. All of us, together.
You know, that's not what I meant.
It's true. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep walking. I'll see you later.
Yeah, I'm fine. No, I just forgot I had to do something. Yeah. I'll see you at Roman's.
Was lunch with your dad, Morag?
Started off all right. We were just talking about the holidays, everything was fine. And then Dad got confused, and he started putting salt in his coffee instead of sugar. He didn't even realise he was doing it.
No, how'd you handle that?
I grabbed the coffee off him and I ran out the door. Not that he knew what I was doing. But I'm fine now. I'm over it.
Take some time to get used to what's happening to your dad. But it's good you're talking about it. It helps to cope.
It's what everyone says. You and Leah. And I appreciate it, I do. It's just that sometimes I don't even know what I'm feeling, let alone how to put it into words.
Maybe me and Leah are the wrong people to talk about it with. You should talk to someone who knows what you're going through. You speak to Charlie much about it?
Not much. She's busy. I don't want her worrying about me as well, Roman.
Rubes, she's your sister.
I'll be all right. Maybe I just don't feel like talking.